Y'all ready?
Ready.
Recording, KP?
Recording.
Episode 8, in case you missed it, give it up for the consistency. We are here. We've got some very special guests. My team is just, they're just traveling the world. My son Eli is in Italy right now with his wife. Justin, fresh off of a run club this weekend. I think he pushed himself a little too hard. He's not feeling well. So I'm here with the legendary, who are you?
Kelly Vo.
Vivian Mai.
Welcome. Welcome to In Case You Missed It.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So if this is your first time listening, In Case You Missed It is a little behind the scenes of what happens here at the Dream Center, aka Case Real Estate. Sharing deals, insights on the market, life hacks, tips and tools. But first and foremost, we always got to start with the ginger shot. So last week was Mothers. This week we, you know, and look, shout out to Mothers. All organic, but it is like straight up ginger. So this is Juju Bar's Fighter Shot. It's got a little bit of pineapple in there, a little bit of cayenne in there, and of course the ginger.
Yummy.
Let's go.
Cheers to immunity.
Absolutely.
Ooh. Okay, that's, it's good.
See that? I like that one.
That's good.
Ooh.
Spicy.
Let's do this. So let's start off with what's new. What's exciting? What's going on here at Case? For this last week, we had some really exciting closings and we had some really exciting openings. Not at liberty yet to share the openings. You gotta wait a little bit more time. I don't wanna jinx anything, but we double ended a very exciting property over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
One that we've been working on for a while. Episode 9, we'll share which property that is. And then Steven Sacedo and I opened escrow on a beautiful home in Newport. And then we closed some good deals. 7-Eleven Ramona,
yeah,
which you were involved with, case closed.
Yeah.
$8,325,000. That was a pretty crazy journey.
Crazy.
What'd you learn from that experience?
I don't know if you remember this, but when we first started working with them,
yep,
I remember going on MLS and just looking up all the houses that have sold within the last, you know, 2 years.
Yeah.
I saw Ramona and I texted it to you. I was like, they would love this house.
I totally did not remember that.
Okay, too bad it sold in January. There's no way.
What?
And then it comes on the market.
Wow. So for those of you who may not know, Vivian has superpowers. So people are always hitting me up and they're like, hey, what does it take to be on Case? What do I need to be on your team? Like, the real estate license is important, I guess, because you legally have to have one to sell real estate, but it's honestly like the least important. I'm looking for people with superpowers, with super high intention, the ability to attract and make stuff happen. How many homes did you show them?
Probably five.
Five homes with two offers written?
Yeah.
Yeah. Incredible. Yeah. That was a wild deal. I've never seen, we won't get too into it for legal reasons, but I've never seen so many memes going back and forth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then they abruptly stopped.
They did abruptly stop.
Yeah. So
we tried to start them back up, but they didn't.
Yeah.
But you know,
it has to flow.
All I know is that our clients are ecstatic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was really great working with them and
with our clients.
Yeah. Yes. Oh yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. Heck yeah. What else have we got going on? Wellington.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Wellington's a beautiful, usually priced at $3.8 million. And right now you get it for the very low City of Orange price. Got a over $2 million discount.
Yeah.
If you're just down to drive like 15 miles. This thing's beautiful. How many square feet?
2,500 square feet on an 8,400 square foot lot.
Single level.
Yeah, single level, five bedrooms, really transformed the space. I feel like every neighbor that walked through this weekend was like, I did not even know this was here.
Mm.
I didn't know that they were doing this, and just positive feedback all around for the house. I think less than 200 people walked through the house this weekend.
So anything people may be hearing on the news about the market or like waiting for stuff to chill out, like
I mean, if anything's, I know I've heard people say, oh, there's a market shift happening. Do you feel the shift? And I'm like, well, for this house, no.
Yeah.
So it's good activity. And for the right price, the right house, it's going to move.
That's
your
awesome.
House is going to move.
That's awesome. And I think we've already got some people who put the pen to paper.
Yeah. Plenty.
Yeah, really cool. Yeah, look it up, y'all. 593 South Wellington. What else we got going on? Run Club this weekend, like the events. There's a lot of events cooking within the K space right now. So we encourage like friends, listeners, be aware of the events because we want to connect with you. Like one of the big things that we're about here is just connecting with people. So a couple events, take these dates down. September the 30th. Is like just one big day of inspiration and laughter. Starting it off with the Run Club, of course. 7 a.m. here at the KASE HQ. Everyone's welcome. All running levels welcome. If you want to bring your bike, we had like Super 73 pull up last week with all these e-bikes. 7 a.m. in the back office. Is stroller gang going down?
Yeah, I just, Marina actually, I'm buying her jogging stroller.
Oh, tight.
Because so
you're running with a regular stroller.
A regular run. That's not.
That doesn't
work. I was
going
to say, I haven't acquired
a
stroller.
I didn't even know.
Did you bring the stroller?
No. Okay. Well, I brought a regular stroller and it's not.
Yeah.
No.
We have one too, but I have a bunch of kids, so I think ours is being used.
Yeah.
All
right, well.
Yeah, all the dads showed up, didn't even tell us about it. All the moms were with the regular strollers.
Yeah.
You guys
had
already
the right
knew.
One.
Yeah, you guys knew.
So September the 30th, y'all, KASE Run Club number 3. The first two have been pretty insane.
Yeah.
This next one, though, is really going to go off, so you don't want to miss it. That same day, we have the very first KASE Fight Night. Like, this is a real thing. Kyle Wade, my right hand, my little bro, who used to be my assistant and has now elevated to one of the best agents within our firm, you know, was just kind of battling it out. Started off as a couple little jokes within the KASE LA squad, and now him and Keven Vigil, they've got a little situation going on and they're gonna handle it.
Oh, he has a new opponent.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so we had a bit of a large weight differential between his original opponent, Pedro.
Mm-hmm.
So now Pedro, PJ, is going to be, you know, he spoke some things. He said, look, I'll fight anybody at Boxing Lab. Those are his exact words. No face mask. He said, I'll fight anybody you got over there around his weight. And so Hunter, who is my daughter's boxing coach, really good dude, him and Pedro are kind of like the main event. Pedro really wanted to be like the main event, and he suggested Kyle be like, what do they call it, KP? The starter? Undercard?
Prelim?
Is that what it is? Prelim?
So there's not the main
fights.
Event. Yeah.
There's two fights. The first one is Kyle and Keven Vigil. They're both around the same weight class. The second one is PJ, the Cobra Romo, and Hunter.
Okay.
And then the Canelo fight afterwards. So we'll be sharing some links at how to reserve your seat. There's limited seating. We're asking to make the investment of $20, which that's gonna go towards the winner, who we'll see what happens, y'all. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
That's fun.
And then the Canelo fight afterwards. The KASE Bounce House is making an appearance.
Dang.
Bunch of cool cars, food. It's gonna be a good time.
Great.
We got the third annual Pumpkins and Porsches coming.
Crazy.
That's insane. What's the date, KP?
October
14th. We have a very special collaboration, which should be official by this time next week, that we could share with you guys. So October 15th, you don't only have to have a Porsche to pull up. If you got something special, whether it be a vintage Land Rover, BMW, could be anything, cool classic VWs, pull up, or no car at all, and you just want to come hang out and have your kids carve some pumpkins. What time does that start at?
We can do 8 to 12.
8 to 12. It's
gonna
be a good time.
It'll be fun.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go. And then your event. What's the date?
October 15th. It's a Sunday. First event for Mom Jeans. I'm super excited.
So dope.
It's coming together.
Are you spelling Mom Jeans like G-E-N-E-S. Yes. Yeah.
Genetic.
Yeah.
That's tight. Yeah. That's awesome.
Shout out to KP on that.
That's pretty dope.
He helped me think of it.
Like, what does that name mean?
Honestly, it's just a play on words of mom genes, yeah. You know, and genetics, you know, it's just a play on word.
Yeah. But like moms have superpowers? Because that's a little bit about what we're talking today.
Well, we definitely do. Yeah. Moms do. All the moms I know, they're superheroes.
I agree.
Yeah,
I agree. My wife is definitely a superhero.
She certainly is.
She's next level. Yeah, she's a fighter. Yeah. You know, Alana was like in jiu-jitsu, she would be like a next level champion for sure.
Absolutely. She should.
Yeah. Let's talk about that. We wanted to talk about some like life hacks, and we decided to have it be like basically tips for moms who are just holding it down, right? I think a lot of the moms that may be listening, they're balancing a little bit of both, right? So I wanted to take a little bit of time and share some of those tips. Eli, Justin, and I, we're usually here sharing dude stuff. Mm-hmm. Wake up at 5:30, 5 in the morning, get in the cold plunge, meditate, run, do an Ironman, blah, blah, blah. So wanted to hear your perspectives about like how to balance it all when you have little human beings to take care of and you hustle. How do you do that?
Well, first, I think just being very intentional with our time. Like I don't have the same time as I did before, you know, having a baby. So if I know I have, let's say, 3 days at the office now, I know I only have these 3 days to do whatever I can to get the same result as I did when I had 5 days.
Yeah.
So just being super intentional with our time, making sure I'm not lollygagging around, and just, you know, utilizing any minute that I have to be productive.
What does being intentional mean to you?
What does it mean to me? As far as like when I'm being intentional?
Yeah, like when you think about being intentional, you know, some people may not fully understand what that means.
Got it.
You know what I mean? Like, what does that mean to you?
So like, let's say I know I have 3 days this week to open an escrow. That's my focus this week. Yeah. So how am I going to open the escrow? I'm going to break it down to how many people do I need to talk to?
Yeah.
If I only have 3 days, how am I going to talk to 100 people? So just being intentional with, let's say, the contacts I make, how many hours I need to spend doing the work, and just being very precise with like everything that I'm doing while I'm at work.
Like, so what I really hear from you is intentionality to you means having a plan.
Yeah.
And not just like, let me just throw some dirt at the wall and see what happens.
Mm-hmm.
See
if it sticks. Like, what's the best way I can utilize my time to get the best results?
That's awesome. So would you say that, like when you think about who you are as a real estate agent, right? You were somebody who last year, it was like, damn, like just consistently, we did the national park deal together, which was this deal where we sold a house in a neighborhood and Kelly went and knocked the neighborhood. Next thing you know, she's like, Kev, can you go meet this seller with me? Potential seller. We go and meet. The seller had no idea who I was, no idea who Case was, but they were very clear that they wanted to work with us. And when I asked the seller, like, hey, why did you choose us? She just said, Kelly's energy, right? So there was that, there was the park deal, which that set a crazy historical record in Huntington Beach. There were like multiple deals that you were involved with and brought to the table that were really exciting. How do you think your role, ability, skill level has shifted now that you're a mom? Would you say that you become a better agent? Has it made your job more challenging?
That's tough. I think it's challenging just knowing like what's on the line.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It's like I enjoy what I'm doing.
Right.
So it's harder just with like the time restraints, I feel like. But as far as the job itself, it's the same.
Yeah.
You know, I'm still here to do what I'm supposed to be doing. So I don't know if it's like gotten harder. It's just it's definitely time blocking and like my schedule needs to be on point.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
From an outside perspective, like my job is to be coach, right? So when I think of when I put my coach hat on and I'm looking at your game, I definitely see you as somebody that has advanced being a mom and an agent mm-hmm. because of that intentionality. And like, not that you weren't serious last year, but it's like it's amplified your moments.
Yeah.
So like you're on this like, you're not here just for small talk. You are here to produce something, and that gets to translate to your client.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
that's
awesome. I do feel also like sometimes I do catch myself like frustrated that I can't prospect, which I didn't expect.
Right.
I'm like, oh my God, like I just want to like be able to prospect right now, and I can. I'll sit there on my notes, and she's jumping all over me. I'm like, remember this, like call this, like these things start coming in. It's just like I don't have that freedom like I did to do the work. So when I'm here, I'm like, okay, I need to focus and be able to do what I need to do.
So what do you tell yourself in those moments for the moms out there who might be listening, who like they have goals, right? They might be entrepreneurs, they might have their own business, and either they're a single mom or maybe their spouse also works.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're trying to work on all this stuff and then the baby's going off and the baby needs attention.
Yeah.
So what do you tell yourself in those moments to like stay in a space of peace and flow and not freak out?
Yeah, well, I'm definitely still learning how to balance it all. But as the months have gone on, like Dylan's almost 8 months now, what I do tell myself honestly is just down to the basics. I'm like, I'm so grateful to be doing what I'm doing. And I'm lucky that I have the time to do what I can. And also that I have support.
Right.
Like, if I need to go to like a random appointment, I know I can call Garrett or his parents or my mom. So maybe sometimes it doesn't work out and I don't get that time, but I know that I have the support to be able to do what I want to do.
Yes.
And I'm going to get there.
Absolutely.
It just, I gotta figure out how, but I will.
Absolutely. Heck yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
You could always bring Dylan to the appointment.
Too. Which I had to last week.
And then I'll fully hold that cute little baby. No problem.
She's so cute.
I mean, I brought her to that event me and Nick did in Spyglass.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Everyone loved her.
Yes.
Yeah. So it was great.
She is so adorable.
Thank you. She is.
All right, Viv. How do you keep it all together, right? How old are your kiddos?
Almost 5 and almost 2.
Right, 5 and 2.
Yeah.
So do you have dual crying ever going down?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, dual crying's no joke.
It's chaos. Like, sometimes when you post and I'm like, I know exactly what Kevin's going through. It's just chaos all the time.
Dual crying is no joke.
Yeah, because they feed off of each other's energy. So one is crying and complaining about something, and the other one's like, oh, that's how you get attention?
Yeah.
I'll do that too. So it's kind of just like, you just live in it. And
your man's is a lifeguard, so he works, right? And so how do you balance all that together?
We honestly have the best family support. And I know there's a lot of people that might not have that same support. But we have my in-laws, we have my parents, we have uncles, other grandparents. Just everyone is on board. And I think it's because I've communicated, like, these are the things that I want to achieve, and in order to do that and be the best mom, like, everyone needs to be on board. And so that's really special that I have that.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's I wouldn't say I have it together by any means, like, but
what's your biggest challenge balancing both?
I think it's just having less time with the kids, and you can never do both. Like 100%. If there's days where I want to spend more time with the girls, that means I'll be doing less prospecting, or I won't be able to hit the numbers that I needed to that day. And then the reverse, I'm going to spend a lot more time at work. There's been days where I'm like coming home at 7:30. I didn't get a chance to make dinner, and you know, but we just have to communicate and know that, you know, I'm grinding for the next 5 years to see what happens, and then we can kind of reevaluate from there. But I think it's good to just have parents, because that's what I grew up with. My parents work super hard, and they still do to this day.
Yeah.
And just your kids watching you and see your work ethic is just going to translate to them, and they know what it takes to...
Well, and making sure you get that fun time in as well, right?
Yeah.
Like, you're working and you're following your passion, you're following your dreams, but then you also got to be able to take off. How long were you gone for?
Oh my gosh. It's like the longest I've been gone ever, I feel like, but 20 days.
20 days, yeah. All throughout Asia.
Yeah, I mean, two countries, yeah. But basically Vietnam and Japan.
Okay.
And that traveling with two kids is next level. And we also traveled with like six other adults, which we did have help, but it's just like, you know, just think like the sleep schedule, the food, and just like the time change. I'm still going through it. Like the kids' schedules are switched around right now. So they're 16 hours ahead still.
Okay.
And my daughter's like sleeping through the day and then awake at night, and then that's when I need to sleep. So
are all moms very similar in that it's very difficult to take time for yourself? Like it is, the amount of things that I would have to try to plan and coordinate, like one of Alana's friends, our friends, was like, oh, you should organize a spa day, da da da. It's like, Alana could organize a spa day if she wanted to organize a spa day. I could attempt to do that. But that's it. There's like just getting her to go and like take a day off and take time for herself is probably one of the most challenging things.
The world kind of stops when, I mean, moms are,
and then also it's really like, what are we going to eat if she goes and does that? You know, I'm going to starve.
Are we going to be good? Yeah. I just feel like moms, not comparing to dads, but just saying moms in general, the minute they open their eyes and the minute they close their eyes, like they've done more than, I don't know.
So
the
whole
population. And I read something, it was funny, but it was like, you literally, like you have 5 minutes of free time. Like, what do you do? There's like a list of a million things you can do, but it's like, you have to pick the most important ones. Like, do I shower? Do I go do the laundry? Do I wash the dishes? Do I, like, can I watch TV? Like, no, there's, you pick one. And that's why I think it's hard to take time. Like, let's go do a spa day. Well, if she does a spa day, what is Alana not doing then?
Right.
So she's picking other important things in to pamper herself.
So moms just have this superpower of just always thinking about others.
Yeah. It's called just the mental workload that they'll always have. It's just, there's always stuff going through our brains. Like, we're probably sitting here right now. It's like, oh, what are the kids doing? Yeah. Like, are they alive? Are they okay? Like, anything.
Well, shout out to the moms. We wanted to take some time just because it's been Eli, Justin, and I talking about, you know, morning routines and prospecting and things like that. And there's a lot of moms. That women's night that we just had at KASE, I just came to pick up Alana's keys because I needed to put gas in her car. And I peeked in, I was like, wow, that was really cool to see.
That was cool.
So shout out to the moms, shout out to all the ladies in real estate, shout out to all female entrepreneurs. It's incredible to watch. I always, you know, tell all the moms at KASE, like, hey, look, you gotta put your familia and your kiddos first, always. But to see y'all do both is really an incredible thing to watch. So keep it up.
Thank you. I just want to say too, like, we really appreciate working for someone like you too that recognizes that, because I feel like some people are, it's easy to be like, oh, well, you know, the men are doing this and the women are doing that.
Yeah.
But like, I know that when I text something like, oh, I have a family obligation, it's like, that's first.
Yeah, you're always like, go handle that.
Yeah. Well, the way I see it is we live by the seven equities. It's very simple. And the seven equities are your mind, your health, and your spirit, right? Mm-hmm. That your spirit is that relationship with yourself, that relationship with God. After that is family, right? After that is your social circle and your friends. Then comes your career and then comes money. If you don't have your first, we're always trying to encourage people, even before the kiddos, which is easier for me to say than for Alana to say, because many times that she's been up all night.
Mm-hmm.
Very rarely do I even, like, I'm out. Like, I am snoring so loud. I don't know why I just started snoring over the last couple years. It's really, she recorded me once. It's super embarrassing. So she's got to deal with that. And she sleeps with like 19 monitors. It looks like it looks like the White House security. You know what I'm saying? It's like this monitor, this baby. There's so many cameras in our house. It's insane. And Alana sleeps with all this right here. I'm like, yo, you know that's like not good to do.
That's,
you know
so
what I mean?
Funny.
So she doesn't sleep. But what was the point of me saying all that? I forgot. Shout out to the moms. Shout out to everything that y'all do.
Shout out to you dads too.
Yes. Hey, we try. Yes. We try. But it's just always, if you're not taking care of yourself, that's what I was saying, those first three equities, it's going to be very difficult to take care of your family. But even more so, if you're not taking care of your family and it's jacked up at home, there's not going to be any way that you can help people with their home. Mm-hmm. Your home's got to be on point first. So that was kind of a bar, that kind of way I tied that together, you know?
Well, me personally, I do want to get to that level where it's like I have everything dialed at home with the kids, with work, to the point where like I can master my routine too.
Yeah.
But I know that, you know, moms, we need to give ourselves some grace sometimes. It's like we're already doing a lot to add that on. It's going to be tough, but it's another challenge that I want to take on for sure.
I was just thinking today, normally Alana makes me some eggs before I leave work.
Yeah, like, I'll just,
bless her.
Yeah, like, and so you get used to that.
Yeah.
And so while I was leaving, I was just like, oh, no eggs. And then, you know, she's like, well, I have a little bit of time. And I was like, oh, I gotta go. I'll just starve. You know what I mean?
Oh my gosh, that's so funny. That actually reminds me because I used to make Garrett lunch every single day.
You're used to that.
Every
day. What am I supposed to do?
And now he's like, now I have to eat frozen again. I'm sorry. I don't have time.
Wow. Well, listen, kudos to y'all. Thank you, everybody who's been listening. Episode 9. We got a lot in store for you. Again, as always, take care of yourself. Remember the 7 equities: mind, body, soul, family, friends, then business, then money. Thank you for listening to In Case You Missed It. Stay focused, stay inspired. We'll talk to you soon. Let's go.